Good morning and welcome to Murlocs Invade Naxxramas with Doc Stout. I am Doc Stout, and if you are just tuning into this series, all of the normal mode bosses from the military quarter are dead, and we have one class challenge remaining and two bosses to look at on heroic. I say look at because there is no reasonable expectation going with such a narrow strategy as Warlock Murloc that we can necessarily defeat any of the heroic mode bosses. To date, I want to say I've brought down one. But before we get to looking at the last two heroic mode challenges, which will probably be the last of our time in the military quarter, with the conscript quarter opening tomorrow, let's take a look at the Warlock class challenge. If you've been watching this series for some time, you know that I typically play Warlock, so this should be of interest to me. Looks like the Warlock is up against the Four Horsemen. And the prize is the Void Caller. 4 mana, 3/4 that has a death rattle to put a random demon. Not particularly useful in a Murloc deck, but if I ever decide to play Handlock or Zoo, maybe. Let's see what is in store for us. Now, if I recall, the trick to the Four Horsemen is that there are three of them that must be destroyed before the fourth, Baron Rivendare, can even be damaged.
Gul'dan versus the Four Horsemen!
The Four Horsemen!
We shall grind your bones to dust!
Your soul shall be mine!
Well. This looks fine. I've been in the habit of keeping my opening hands in these class challenges.
Invader, turn away while you still can.
Oh. Come, Zeliak. Let us have our fun.
All right.
Enough prattling. Let them come. Bring it on, you sniveling orc.
That's brutal. May end up being a little bit longer game than I thought. Paladin Secret? What? Alright, let's start with, I guess, Sense Demons. Pass the turn.
Job's done.
Alright, we'll start dropping Void Callers pretty much every turn, as he's dropping Paladin Secrets and we're taking 3 damage per turn. I don't know how many times I want a life tap here.
From the void, I come.
What just happened? Reduce its health. Oh, that's fine. I can live with that. They'll probably just ignore it, but,
From the void, I come.
Alright. We're gonna burn through our hand real fast. Burning through his hand even faster. Don't want a Doomguard at the moment.
To the void.
Take down one.
Touché.
Return it to life with one health. Brutal.
Job done.
Oh, that's fine.
The Scourge will consume
you! Came out without having to discard the 2 cards. That's pretty sweet.
Touché.
Ah! probably time for the Dread Infernal.
A paltry task.
Job done.
As it should be.
Random friendly minion, +3/+2. Alright, you can handle that. Alright. Everybody gets a damage.
Job's done.
Well, that's all I've got. I'm gonna need demons to finish this off. Hopefully, we're done here. Corruption's not gonna get you there, bud. And it appears that we win. Once again, the class challenge is not particularly difficult. Warlock challenge is complete. Now for the hard part of the day. We're going to at least get one look at each of the Heroic Mode bosses that remains. We've already taken on Instructor Vesuvius. So we'll move on.
Look, if you give up now, I will tell Gothik not to turn you into
a
disembodied soul.
Gothic's ability has been buffed. It only costs one. And now it's draw a card and gain a mana crystal. Ugh. Now, traditionally, if you've watched the stream, I've made mistakes with Gothik the Harvester. I've decided that I'm going to kill his enemies that give me zero force that cause one damage. I'm going to try and keep those guys in mind this time.
Gul'dan versus Gothik the Harvester!
My minions never truly die.
Mine do.
Your soul shall be mine!
Get rid of Hellfire. Doesn't seem particularly useful. Our traditional turn one play. Warlock Tidecaller. Man, that ability is
Bring
powerful.
Out your dead.
He's just ramping all the way up. Wow, a 2-3. And my guy's dead. I can see how this is gonna go. He's already at
Kill my minions if you like. Their souls will pay you a visit.
Right, I have to very quickly get the leader in. Get in for some damage. See what we can do here.
What friends?
You dead! Return!
Google. Very quickly. It deals two to all other characters. To attack him. Not feeling so good about my chances.
Ride four.
Five. Yes, we continue on despite the fact that Battlecry does nothing. Alright, so it's turn 5, he's at 10 mana.
What we do?
It's Taunter.
Shields up!
6-5. 5-6.
This is it.
This is ludicrous. And not only do I believe that this deck can't beat it, I'm not even sure that I own the cards that can pull together a deck that can beat this. Yeah, pretty much everything ends me here.
Get it up,
yeah, I can't I'll never take me alive, copper. So aggroed out. Drawing cards and ramping up for one mana every turn. Seems fair. Alright, let's see how much more unfair the Four Horsemen are.
The Four Horsemen are my most powerful Death Knights! I'm looking forward to this.
Probably I'll have like 20 life.
Gul'dan versus the Four Horsemen!
We shall grind your bones to dust!
Your soul shall be mine!
Yeah, let's replace the old lights here. They've still only got 7. He's got 14, so that's a little different. They also do 2 apiece, which means that they can straight up kill my Tidecaller. So he's got double life, they have double attack power. And of course, Paladin Secrets. Alright, I think I feel a little bit better about this play.
Job's done.
They can still attack my Murlocs directly. They'll take a little bit of damage to do so. I'd love to get in for value with the Knife Juggler, but it doesn't look like it's gonna happen. Next turn, I can Knife Juggle and Bluegill Warrior. That doubling of attack power is significant, though. You might not need any big tricks.
Put this apple on your head!
See any reason not to. Actually, I do see a reason.
I didn't have enough mana. It doesn't matter, he kills me this turn. But not if I can kill me first. Yeah. Alright, that was heroic mode. These modes pretty obviously not intended to be beat by hyper-aggressive strategies like some of the things in the Arachnid Quarter. And even that said, I only managed to do one of the bosses in the Arachnid Quarter on Heroic without really retooling the deck. So, this will mark the end of our time in the Military Quarter. I'm not going to continue to beat mine or my Murloc's heads against the wall. I'd like to thank you for watching. I will be back hopefully tomorrow, presuming that everything is stable with the launch of the Construct Quarter, to take a look at the new bosses
and new class challenges in the next week or so. Thanks for watching. This is Doc Stout signing off. Murgle on, my friends.